It's an absolutely glorious summer's day here in Yorkshire, as it always is at this time of year. And we're here at our smart home takeover, and today we're looking at hot water heating with a product we've seen on the channel before, the Eddi energy diverter. Now, as I'm sat here in this glorious sunshine, there's currently 1 kilowatt of power being exported from the solar panels on the roof back to the grid. Now, the purpose of the energy diverter is to put that into the hot water tank. Now, problem there, you may not believe it, but sometimes it rains in Yorkshire. Sometimes we have no sun. What about those winter months when we have no sun at all? How do we heat our hot water? And yes, we're going to have to use the existing gas heating system. So in this video today, we're going to look at fitting this relay board that will allow the Eddi to be the primary control of our hot water function, but also integrate back up from the existing gas heating system. It may be hot outside, but it's even hotter inside because I'm stood next to this hot water cylinder that's primed full of red hot water that was heated by the gas earlier this morning. So top tip, if you're ever doing that, tell the owner to switch the heating program off when you're going to be working in the cupboard. But we're going to pay the price here. And what is that price? Well, the price is that the gas heating has been used to heat that water cylinder up, where we could have, on a glorious day like this, used the diverted energy from the solar panels. So what we're going to do now is fit the relay card such that the Eddi energy diverter can interrupt the gas central heating to take priority over it. So what we really want to happen is, during the day, as the homeowner's out, there's no EV to charge, that energy goes into the hot water cylinder to heat the hot water. But if it looks like it's getting on towards the end of the day, the owner's due to come home from work and there isn't enough hot water that's been heated by the solar panels, the gas heating will kick in and make sure we've got enough hot water for the evening.
So before you fit the relay card, I can see you've got the EV Comply app open. What's the thinking behind that?
Well, we may have misplaced the instructions last time, but fear not, Gary, because they're in the knowledge base section of EV Comply. So just have a look at the Eddi manual, and there we've got a digital copy of it, always to hand if you're using that app.
And we've looked at EV Comply in another video. I'm sure you'll put it in the eye above our heads or in the link in the description, because it's a fantastic tool for EV charging installs.
Yeah, so there was our showing the relay card instructions. So now we're just looking for the right wiring diagram here. We're going to fit this as part of an S-Plan system, but there's lots of other variants this can this relay card can go into. So just dial through to find the right one.
Well, it's like all bases covered, because I've seen a lot of heating systems before we get to that S-Plan system.
Yeah, but again, this is there's quite a modest heating system here. There's a lot more complicated systems you can put in there.
So once we've found the right instructions, which are there, we're ready to make those connections now?
Yeah, that's it. So just remove the cover of our Eddi.
You got any top tips when taking the cover off?
Well, when dealing with small screws, Gary, I like to put them back in so we don't lose them, especially when there's plumber's parts behind there. We could drop something behind something and not get them back.
Can you just explain the connections to me?
Yes, so just as a quick recap. So there's our incoming supply that comes from the fuse spur. So essentially we've ran the supply to the immersion heater through the Eddi unit, and there's the output to the heaters. There's the option for two heaters.
And that little cable there?
That's the one we're going to use to tap into the S-Plan wiring system once we've fitted our relay card.
Oh, right, so it's just two connections on the relay card. Is there many connections on there?
There is. It's quite a busy card because, as we saw in those wiring diagrams, there's lots of different options there in terms of what it can do. And we're going to use one of the simplest ones here. We just need to make two wired connections across one of the relays. But first, we have to fit it. Looking for a little ribbon cable and some PCB spacers that we find in there.
Okay, a bit of care now, would suggest.
Yeah, that's my hands are possibly a little bit too big for this, but I can take me back to my electronics roots here.
Okay, so it's going to stand on those studs and just clip into place, is that right?
Yeah, so the spacers just clip into the motherboard on that of the Eddi, and then we'll just insert our ribbon cable into the slot there, just to the side of the LCD screen.
Well, that seemed easy.
Yeah, and there's no other commissioning to do. The unit will recognise it's got a relay card.
Wow, so it's just a couple of connections now, but as it's a connection, I would suggest I'm going to see a ferrule crimping tool in a minute.
Yeah, since it's a fine stranded conductor, just in case we have to remove it. I'm not saying we make any mistakes in wiring, but it does happen sometimes.
Well, I noticed you'd ferruled everything else in there, so I knew we wouldn't be getting away with it. It wouldn't be an eFIXX video without a ferrule in. So pop those two connections in and then you'll be down into the S-Plan heating system itself?
So two connections here, again, just across a normally open relay contact that clicks in to instigate the heating. So again, just careful, small screwdriver for those terminals because it's a PCB terminal, so we don't need to over-tighten them.
Well, that was easy.
Yeah, and then again, just pop the cover back on. And then we're ready to start looking at the integrating it into our existing S-Plan system. And if you're wondering, yes, it is incredibly hot in here, and I am sweating, so I do need a drink. And luckily, we've got this Replenishh water bottle. If you don't know who Replenishh are a specialist distributor of EV charging equipment, but they also cover the Myenergi Eddi product that we're using in this video as well. So check out their website and link below, and I'm going to enjoy this water that's been chilling in the freezer. So we fitted the relay card into the Eddi Energy Diverter module, and that relay card is now going to take over the boost function for the gas heating. So that means we don't need the existing heating timer that's upstairs next to the boiler. So we've gone up and we've removed that. It's also not needed for the central heating system as well, because previously in this series we fitted an Netatmo smart heating thermostat that also has a timer function in it. So now we've completely taken that timer out of the circuit. If you haven't seen the videos about the Netatmo smart thermostat, check out the description, or we will put an eye somewhere above my head for those videos. So the next stage is we now just need to connect our relay board via the Myenergi Eddi diverter into our S-Plan heating system. So that's a case of removing the cover behind us.
So you should take the cover off this Wago junction box for the central heating. Remind me of the part number.
That would be the 207-4301. Check out the video we made showing how we used it to correct the wiring in this cupboard that we inherited in a previous video.
It's got the ratcheting mechanism we really like on the cord grips, and also they're stackable, and it's just two connections on which part of the circuit you're going to interrupt.
Yeah, so I'm just going to add, I've added another Wago block in there, and we're just going to interrupt the power that flows in and out of the cylinder stat. So again, we're going to switch the water demand on or off using that relay card.
So quite a simple process when you've obviously worked out where those connections are within the join box.
Yeah, so this is an S-Plan Plus wiring system, so there's quite a bit going on in here, but yeah, it is just two simple connections to integrate the Eddi into the wiring and then cover back on. Wow, that was thirsty work. It wasn't strenuous work, but it was incredibly hot in that cupboard next to the hot water cylinder. But we've fitted that relay card in there, and it now will trigger the gas heating to boost the amount of hot water available in that tank. Now, on that card, we use the very simple option, just coupling it into this S-Plan heating system. There's a lot of other options on there. You can use the other relay to trigger another heating element, or perhaps if you've got a lot of solar in the installation, you could use that excess to start warming an underfloor heating system as well. Other options on there, you can add a temperature sensor to actually monitor the temperature of the water in the tank. Unfortunately, this cylinder didn't have that facility, so we couldn't use that on there. It will also, you can couple in the input from an Economy 7 system as well, if you wanted to use the off-peak heating as a trigger to start that boost function as well. So that's all built in there, a lot of powerful features in that relay board. One thing you haven't seen during this video, and if you've seen our Eddi video that we made before, is a current transformer, because the Eddi itself needs some signal to find out how much power's been exported from the property. But as you'll see on that, we were measuring it because we saw that in the app, and now that 1 kilowatt of power that was leaving the building as an export is now being diverted into the hot water tank behind us. So where does the system get its current transformer information from? The secret we've covered in another video in the Harvi. The Harvi is a wireless current transformer that not only provides the current signal for this, it also provides a current signal for the EV charger we fitted in another video. And that's a really clever bit of kit, so I recommend you check that out. But as ever, have you fitted the Eddi Energy Diverter from Myenergi? What did you use the relay card to trigger? Have you used the relay card? Or have you got any other questions about what we've covered in this video? This, again, quite a simple installation. You know, we've maxed it out with our renewable technology, but we would appreciate your comments on the kind of projects you're working on. So please fire some comments in below and ask any questions that you might have.